Hello everybody, welcome back to another video, and today we have with us Ansh Mehta from the University of Wisconsin. He is currently pursuing his Bachelor's in Computer Science and will be graduating with the class of 2023. Before I introduce you to Ansh Mehta, I would like to highlight some of his achievements. And these achievements, let me tell you, these achievements were achieved by him during his high school days. So he had this startup named Tuxedo, which was a startup which basically dealt with industrialists, and it automated the MIS systems of those industrialists. And to name a few with whom he worked, is the best example would be Reliance, and that is, I hope, is the biggest achievement of Ansh during his high school days. So now let me present you Ansh Mehta from the University of Wisconsin and a batch of 2023.
Hi, thank you for that introduction, Achintya. Am I saying your name correctly? I'm doing pretty good.
Yeah.
You?
Okay. I'm also doing great. So let me have some quick questions. Like, when did you decide of going abroad and making your study abroad program? And how did you start your process and all the different aspects? So can you give a briefing about
it? I think I made up my mind when I was in 11th grade. I went to high school in Giri Goenka. I'm actually from Punjab. I'm not from Delhi, but I moved to Delhi because I wanted to go to IIT. And I'm not sure if you're aware or not, the Vidya Mandir classes, I used to take those. So they basically prepare you for IIT entrance exams and stuff. And while I was taking those classes, I realized that it's not my speed. Like, the way they teach there, I was like, no, I need to learn, hands-on, practical. And I prefer a much more holistic education than just, focusing on textbook stuff. So that's when I was like, okay, I'm going to go to the U.S. I'm not going to study in India. And I started working from 11th grade, 12th grade, gave my SAT, took my APs, my subject tests, my TOEFL, all that jazz. And, now I'm here.
That's great. So, how difficult was your transition? You said that you were preparing for the IITs initially. So how difficult was that from shifting from the IIT program to the SAT program or studying abroad program?
It wasn't that hard of a turnaround, honestly. But the only thing was that it was a complete opposite direction of where I was heading, so I had to pull a complete 180, because with the IIT prep, I was studying several hours a day out of a textbook, practicing math and all that stuff. Whereas for SATs and stuff, they're not that hard, especially for us Indians. We study a lot of stuff in high school that people in America don't study in high school. So all that stuff wasn't that hard. What was hard was figuring out what to write in the essays, editing them, talking to people, figuring out how you're supposed to present yourself. Because for admissions to the US, you have to sell yourself. In India, it's you take an exam, you get a good rank, and you're automatically in. There's not much you have to do. But in the US, basically the way it works is you write an essay, you put your entire high school and previous career down on paper, and you're supposed to present your personality to the admissions officers, and then they sit in a committee and then take a call on whether to let you in or not. So that's kind of a hard 180 to pull, but the process itself was a lot of fun, and it wasn't crazy.
That's cool. But with the new education policy coming in, I hope that India will also have some changes, quite a lot of changes in the education system. And I hope for the best at the earliest, so that the next upcoming generation can avail those benefits.
And so, I know. I heard about it and I was very happy. I'm sorry, I interrupted you.
No, you can go on.
Okay. I heard about the NEP 2020 and it was I
Yeah.
was really happy. I mean, I was kind of pissed that I had to go through the more strenuous Indian high school experience as it is, traditionally, but power to the people who are in high school right now. Good luck. Good on you.
So can you like give some insights and how different is the environment in India? And like, because you are okay, let me make it easier. Like, you are in computer science, so can you have some insights of the Indian perspective and the like US perspective? Like, what are the differences in your field and what experiences, what more experiences or the benefits you get in US than rather than in India?
Okay. Well, I obviously haven't been to college in India, so I can't really comment on that. But from what I've heard from my friends and my experiences in high school, the major differences that I can tell here in the US education, higher education system is that here they prefer like a more holistic education. Because I have to take, as a computer science student, I don't want to say forced, but I am forced to take a lot of classes that I wouldn't otherwise have taken if I wasn't here. Like in India, I would just follow a path that's set out for that everyone else is taking. And it's like you take your computer science subjects, you take a few engineering subjects here and there, and then you're done. You got your degree, you're out. But here, I have to take my general education and stuff, and I enjoy it a lot. Like I was averse to it initially, but it's been a lot of fun, and like it's made me think in ways that I wouldn't have thought before, and I really appreciate that. So I think that's another change that they can bring about in Indian colleges too, which would make it a lot better, is to focus on the overall development of a student rather than just rote knowledge. I mean, Indian students, especially from the IITs and stuff, do tend to fare better when it comes to the technical aspects, especially in computer science. I don't know much about other subjects, but in STEM usually. Whereas here it's more of a well-rounded thing,
Just like as you are expressing the word holistic review, so what are the extracurriculars that you have done or something that you really look forward in your university?
Oh, okay. I mean, we have at Madison, we have a lot of clubs. Pretty much anything you want to do, any club you want to join, you can. I've joined several clubs. I wasn't an active participant in any, but I plan to be this semester going forward. For example, I joined the AI club, which, obviously I'm
Yeah.
interested in AI, so. I also joined the aviation club because the US is one of the cheapest countries in the world to get your pilot's license and to be able to fly and get a plane and stuff. I plan on joining Formula SAE, which is our own in-house Formula racing team. We race against other colleges and stuff, so that's very interesting because it's a combination of two of my biggest passions, racing and computer science. And there's all sorts of things you can do.
That's pretty interesting. The formula racing is quite like will appeal to more viewers, like. So, like, what are the it's a random question, like, what are the three habits that you want to inculcate or like have in the future days that will enhance your life or the way of living?
I need to start waking up earlier than usual. I have a habit because what I tend to do is study late into the night or work late into the night or watch a movie or whatever and then wake up super late. So I need to like start cutting myself off before midnight, hopefully, and try to go to sleep before that. Another habit that I actually have been working on is getting my work done on time, because it's very tempting, especially with online classes, to push your work off until as late as possible, which doesn't always work out. It's pretty much worked out for me so far, but it's not like a great position to be in. So that's one. And then for a third one, I don't know. Those are pretty much the top two. Maybe like eating healthier. Like that also gives you a lot of energy to work and stuff.
Okay, so like, can we have some fun facts about you?
Some fun facts about me. Fun. What's fun? I'm a gamer. I used to play CS:GO. I don't as much anymore, but I played in a couple tournaments. I don't know if that's fun, but yeah, I'm super hard into gaming these days. I'm playing more VR games. simulation racing, sim racing and Formula One, all that stuff. It's a lot of fun. So yeah.
Okay. So last of all, like I would ask, like have a message for the upcoming, like aspiring students who want to like have a similar path, like go study abroad in the US or maybe other some different countries. So what are the messages that you would like to give, and what are the tips that they should follow, like to have an easier path of going abroad and studying?
Well, first of all, the first step that you need to do and like you need to make in coming abroad is you need to be absolutely sure that you want to go abroad. You can't be like half and half, comme c'est comme ça. Like I may not. Make up your mind and then set your mind to it, and then put all your eggs in that basket. If you make up your mind in time, which is usually around 10th or 11th grade, you can start working towards building out your resume, preparing for the test, preparing for the essays, and kind of focusing on that mindset. Whereas if you're like, yeah, I might go, but I might not, and then you end up taking your SATs, but you don't actually score well, you don't actually write out your essays and all that, there's no way you're getting in. So like you need to focus in one direction. It's not hard when you focus. It's just that you have to be conscious of what you're doing and where you're putting your efforts towards. That's probably my number one advice. But secondly, just work on building out your resume and your personality so it's presentable for the admissions council.
So I hope that will help many aspiring students or upcoming students who like will are planning to study abroad. And I would like to thank you for your precious time and making
Oh,
out
absolutely.
time for this video. And I really enjoyed it, and hoping to have a great conversation with you later on also.
Yeah,
Thank
absolutely.
you.
Thanks for calling.
And future, and I hope you all the best for all the future endeavors and like passing out with flying colors in the batch of 2022 at Wisconsin. Okay.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Okay, bye.